Chapter 3, that's Miss Sugar Mama to you. As the old adage go, it's hard out here for a pimp. But in the case of the side chick, who's pimping who? Sometimes Lola felt like contortionist extraordinaire when it came to robbing Peter to pay Paul in order to present herself as the fluent, if not affluent, happy-go-lucky girl which her man needed her to be. Because after all, who wants a side chick that you have to support? Here's a sample from Chapter 3.
When Calvin called Lola, he called her with instructions for her to find him a cheap motel to stay in for a few nights until he could get his wife to calm down and take him back. What bothered Lola the most was that after Calvin insisted on her finding him a hotel room, he never gave her his credit card number to pay for the reservation. He barked out the orders and left Lola to fill in the blanks. Calvin had plenty of money, but he was selfish. He never paused to consider that she may not have had the resources to complete this task. These were the things that Lola had allowed to get out of control with him in their relationship. Extrapolated from the pages of his award-winning book, The Four Women That Men Desire, Sir Walter Jones has given a face, a life, and the backstory to Girl A, and her name is Lola. The way she walks, the way she talks, and her swag are the layered garments of protection stripped away from this character's seemingly incredulous life. No, this is not a read for Mother Johnson's book club, but it's a cautionary and insightful look into the making of a side chick. Which girl are you, and what's your backstory? Find out as you delve into the pages of this must-read, Lola, Lady of Sorrow.
We'll be right back.